This is the leading research university on design in the world. So if you're already designing in here, you know that you're doing something new and something that the world would need.
In our teaching, we look at different levels. And there's a first level of what is human experience? That's theory. A second layer, which is about how do you get to these experiences? What kind of research methods do you have for that? And then the third layer is, if you have those insights, how do you that actually apply that in design projects?
You get a product at the beginning, you start analyzing it, exploring it, doing tests with it. So you learn to set up a really good user test and analyze it on a deeper level. Not only what people do and what they say, but also what they think and why they do something specific.
Exploring interactions is diving into a specific context and looking at the product-user interactions that are going on there. Then translating insights from those interactions into a new vision on how you as a designer would want the interaction to be. And making that into a concrete product or service.
So with interactive technology design, the starting point is really the technology and what you can do with that. And they really want you to start utilizing those new interactive technologies like Arduino and really see what you can, what kind of products and concepts you can come up with that.
Interaction plays a role in all the courses in different ways. Sometimes zooming in on detailed human product interactions, sometimes zooming out, looking at what people, what kind of interactions people have when they go through a particular activity. But interactions are always present in all the courses. It's impact-driven design. It's not about products, it's not about services, but it's about the impact that it has on the user.
What you're mostly doing in the Master for Design for Interaction, you're designing for emotions and you cannot predict emotions. So what you're doing, you're designing a product, you put it in the context, then you're testing it, then you reflect on it, then you design something again, then you test it, then you reflect on it, and that way it's a very iterative way of designing, and in that way finally come to the emotions or the reactions that you want to make and create people with.
During this course, I really learned to prototype fast. You get the tools to make something quickly, something interactive quickly. And really go out to the user and try it out.
What we want our students to learn is two basic things. First is empathic research, and second, how to translate the insights that come from that research into novel concepts. Design for Interaction has quite a strong research focus. There's a lot of research involved in the courses, because you have to learn how to understand users through research. But research is also used to generate the knowledge that we teach you.
But I really like that you were working with the international students because they see things in a different way and you can build on that further.
What really surprised me is that I have a lot of freedom in my project that I'm doing here and the topics that I choose and the things I want to address. And I'm really happy surprised about that.